Job. Job 5 verse 12. The Bible says, he disappointed the devices of the craft, so that their hands cannot perform their enterprise. Let me pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, Lord, I commit your word into your hand. I pray, O God Almighty, God who disappoints the enemies, who disappoints the works of their enterprise. Lord, I praise your name and I pray that God will bless your people. And Lord, my Father, every attack of the enemy, let it be frustrated and be disappointed in Jesus' name. Wherever the enemy is planning to do this morning or this afternoon or whatever time is in your country, wherever you are, any plans of this devil, every schemes of the enemy planning against your life and your family, let it be disappointed. Let them be disappointed in Jesus' name. I am going to disappoint the crafts of the enemy so that they cannot perform the enterprise. That's what the Bible says. Therefore, in the name of Jesus Christ, Lord, I thank you because you are God. Lord, we worship you and we honor you. We glorify your name. We magnify your name. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, I pray. Amen. Father, I raise up a standard of the Holy Spirit to come against every plans of the devil, every works of the enemy, every activities of the devil, any psychic prayers, every activities of witchcraft and of sorcerers. Let them be wasted in the name of Jesus. Your word says, the word of God says that the Lord will disappoint the devices of the craft, so that their enterprise, their hands cannot perform their enterprise. The Lord Almighty will disappoint every works of the devil. The enemy will be frustrated, will be disappointed. That's why to know how to attack the strategy of their enemies. Because God himself is going to disappoint him. He's not going to succeed. Anything he has planned against your life, against your children, against you, it is going to be frustrated. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. The Bible says in the Second Corinthians 2 verse 11 says, lest Satan should get an advantage of us, for we are not ignorant of his devices. We are not ignorant of devices of the devil. We know that he is a thief. He came to destroy, to steal, and to kill. Therefore, we are not ignorant. Anything the enemy is planning, I destroy them in Jesus' name. Father, in the name of Jesus, I pray right now by the power in the blood of Jesus, I pray for you. Let all rivers, trees, forests, evil companions, evil pursuers, pictures of dead relatives, snakes, spirit husband, spirit wife, masqueraders, manipulated against you in the dreams, be completely destroyed by the power in the blood of Jesus Christ. I am speaking against every satanic dream. Dreams in the forest, dreams in the rivers, dreams in the trees, dreams of evil companion. Evil companion that comes to you while you are sleeping. I command them, all of them, be destroyed in Jesus' name. I am speaking the word of God because the Bible says the Lord Almighty will destroy and disappoint the works of the enemy. Therefore, the strategy of the enemy is to be wasted, to attack them. Whenever they come on you, you will force, you go to attack them and destroy their ways, what they are planning against you. In the mighty name of Jesus, don't be silent, don't be quiet. When the enemy comes to you, they plan evil, they deposit sickness on you, they chant on you, they spells on you. You have to attack them. You have to attack their strategy. You have to attack their ways. You have to block them in Jesus' name, like the way we are doing. When you pray those prayers, you destroy their ways. That's why the Bible says they will be disappointed, because they were thinking that they are going to achieve, they are going to succeed to attack you. But when you know their target, when you know how to attack them, they cannot penetrate. They can't get you. In the name of Jesus Christ. That's why you see the police, they have to investigate and know how did the enemy come. You find it is too late when the enemy has come and destroy you and left you. When the enemy has come and bomb you and leave you. So it's good to know when he's planning to come and do this so that you can attack them before they can attack you. If you don't attack them, they will attack you and do damage you and run away. So therefore, you have to learn how to attack them. While they are planning to come and attack you, you will attack them before they attack you. They come always. That's when you set fire against their camp. You send conviction. While they are planning the way to come and attack you, you send, let the angels of God. God is having angels and uses the angels. When you ask the angels of God to go ahead of you and destroy their camp, to confuse, ask the Holy Spirit, because the Holy Spirit is a sword. God will raise up the Holy Spirit and go. When God was talking to the angels in heaven, he was asking, whom can I send? God was talking to the spirit. And that's why I'm telling you that God can release a deadly spirit to go to the camp of the enemy and destroy them and disappoint them. God Almighty, he is a God. When you have good relationship with him, he will work for you and he will fight for you. God is good God to fight for you than you yourself fighting. Because remember, we are not fighting against flesh and blood. We fight against principalities and powers and rulers of darkness. Therefore, that's why we go in the spirit. Thank you very much, my friends. Thank you for joining. I want you to listen this word. It is made for you. And I'm telling you that your life will not be the same again. Amen. People have suffered a lot. People are living in darkness. They don't know what to do. This is spiritual warfare prayer. That's why we know how to attack the enemies. The enemies of your breakthrough. Wherever you want to do this, they come and fight you lost. How many contracts have you lost? How many jobs have you lost? How many divorces have you gone? That is the works of the enemy. You need to be happy and live happy marriage, happy children, and you need to be, do you know how to fight the enemies? There are witchcraft power that has been programmed in you, making you cannot go anywhere. There are witchcraft, really witchcraft, evil powers of the enemy. The witchcraft, they are all over. And if you want to know that they are there, because the Bible says, don't let the witch to live. That's why God has asked us to cast them and remove them from people. People, they are living in curses. You wonder some people, they change. They are sick all the time. They have different issues. Yeah, children are ups and down. Look at our youths. Go to the street and watch them the way they are. It's not them. It's the spirit that has been spells on them. They are wasting them, majority of youths. So God Almighty, may they deliver our youths from the hands of witchcraft, from the hands of the enemy. We have to attack these enemies who is taking away our family, our children. It's not fun when you see the children are being wasted like this. So we pray that God Almighty will stop this. That's why we have to target the works of the enemy. God Almighty has sent me to pass this message to you. How to attack the strategy of the enemies. We should learn how to attack the enemies. We don't have to sit down and watch the enemies coming to destroy our homes, coming to destroy our cities. We have to launch an attack that will put him a stop in the name of Jesus Christ. I pray that anybody who is hiring witch doctor to curse you, let them be destroyed in Jesus' name. Thank you, friends, for joining. God bless you. I am praying for you. I command every evil plantation in your life to come out with all the roots in the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ, I pray that I dismantle and destroy every power working against you in Jesus' name. Every evil power working against you, I dismantle them and destroy them in Jesus' name. In the name of Jesus Christ, I pray that let the sword of Goliath, of poverty working against you, be destroyed in Jesus' name. You know the Goliath has a weapon. He was having a weapon when he came to, hallelujah, press. Thank you so much. Thank you from Israel. I love you and I thank God for you. So I'm talking, you remember Goliath, he was a giant. He was cursing the children of Israel every day for 40 days. When the little boy, a boy called David, saw him, he looked at him and he said, who is this uncircumcised? Who is this man? Then David went and attacked him. He did not fear him. That's how you should go. You don't have to fear the enemy. The enemy will curse you, will frustrate you, will try to put fear on you so that you can run away. He knows that if he comes in the spirit of fear, you will run away. He comes by disappointing, discouragement. So when he discourages you, he curses you, he frustrates you, he started cursing you using their gods, like the way Goliath was doing to Philistine, to the children of Israel. When Goliath was every day was coming out and cursed the children of Israel, they were cursing the children of God. Every day for 40 days until David said, Goliath, you don't know our God. I will come to you and I will kill you today. Today is your end. Then Goliath says, you think I'm a dog? Who are you? I'm going to give you the dog and birds of the air. David says, try, you'll see. David didn't fear this giant man. So any problem you are facing today, don't fear that problem. It will go. It is going to be punished and destroyed in Jesus' name. Anything that is in front of you, as you believe the word of God, God himself will fight for you. He will send his angels. Remember, he sent one angel. And this angel went and destroyed 185,000. So you don't have to fear any problem you are facing today. If that is sickness, God will send fire and melt that sickness from your body. If it is poverty, poor, God himself is the owner of silver and gold. In treasure in heaven, there is a lot of money. He will release the blessings because this year, next year, it is an open door. As you follow me, we pray together. I'm going to prophetically prophesy to you, and God is going to release the blessings of God to you. These blessings, the open door is for the children of God, not for the children of the devil. If you follow me, you will see how much God is going to bless you. Your business is going to grow. You will be promoted. You are going to have more blessings than before. You will be healed. You will be set free in the name of Jesus. Doors are going to open, multiple doors. Windows of oven is open. Showers of blessing is coming again. 2 years ago, we had the showers of blessing. And now it's going to come again. The year we had the showers of blessing, people were blessed. People, they were flowing with the blessings of God. So next year is an open door. It's an open window. Heaven is going to open for people so that they can, the blessings will flow. And I'm telling you that God Almighty, God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob has heard you and is coming to bless you in Jesus' name. Thank you very much, my sister, for joining. Our God is going to meet your needs according to his riches. You have cried enough. You have cried so much. Enough is enough. You have to go with God. And this is the word of the living God, that God Almighty will be going to meet your needs. He's going to open doors and windows of heaven according to Malachi 3, verse 3. You, if you read the whole Malachi, you will see he's going to rebuke the devourer. He's going to stop everything that has been eating you, that has been destroying you, that all the sickness. You look at the Malachi 3 verse 11. The Lord is going to revoke the devourer. The only condition is there that you have to be faithful. Thank you so much. Yes, thank you. Thank you. The word of God is true. It will never void it. We are going to live in the book of Malachi 3. If that's why the Malachi is for the blessings of God and the curses of God is there. Because this is the curses will go to the enemies and the children of God will take the blessings. It is the same time like Deuteronomy 28, the blessings of God and the curses of God. So the children of that devil will receive their curses. People who does not give their tithes and offering to the church, they don't serve God, they won't get these blessings. But the people are faithfully serving God and who love God, they will flow in these blessings because it is open window from heaven and it is going to flow to you. That's why I'm asking you to donate to our ministry, because I am standing in the gap to pray for you. Go to our website and donate any amount you can donate. If you don't have a church, you give your tithes and offering to our ministry. We will pray for you. God is standing. God is our awesome God. And I pray that God will bless you mightily. God, our God, is a God who answers by fire. It's God.